Hi, I'm Paul Wells from Agile J. In previous videos, we've looked at how we can define our own domain-specific language, and within that DSL, we can set up records. Those records can be given primitive attributes like strings and integers, or more complex attributes like references to other records. And also we've seen that we can apply multiplicity, that we can apply different options within the constructs of the language, and things like that. There's actually a lot more that can be done with DSLs, but I don't really want to go any deeper into the definitions of DSLs at this stage. But what I would like to do is show you in this video how you can define your own validation of the content that the user has entered. Firstly, let's have a look what the problem is. J1237, and its title is nothing, and give it some pages and say that it's a hardback. That's fine. There are no errors, but obviously it's not fine because the title is empty. So how can we fix that? Well, if you look inside the language project, you will see that there's a package called the validation. So if you go into there and then open this file, the validator, you will see that XText has generated for us an example of how we can build our own validation. So the first thing we need to do is to let it know that it's a checking method, is use the annotation, check, and I need control space to get that to finish. And then we give the method a name, check title is not empty, and that will take a parameter which will be a book. It's a book that we're checking, so we need book control space, and it's this one here, and we'll call the parameter book. Now down inside here, what we want to do is say, and we could take this as an example, if book get title dot is empty, so that's our error condition, and then there's a method which we are inheriting from this validator, error, and that takes two parameters. The first one is the error string, so that would be title cannot be empty, and then the second parameter is the what's called the feature. What it means is it's telling where in the document the error actually is. And taking the example again, we've got demo DSL package, and it's actually book title. So that gives it the scope of the error. So let's save that, and well, sometimes because we've actually only altered the Java, sometimes it doesn't need a restart, but it seems this time it does need a restart. So let's try again now. Let's make a new record, and this time let's give it an empty title, and as you can see, it's complaining already. And it says, well, first of all, let's make it a valid record otherwise. So we'll give it a number of pages and we'll tell it it's a hardback. Right, now the only error remaining is this one, and it says title cannot be empty. Firstly, let's have a look what the problem is. Let's give this book a title. And let's give it a sequel. And let's say that this is a sequel of J1237, which is itself. So that shouldn't be allowed to happen. So let's check now that a book is not a sequel of itself. Again, it takes a book parameter, and the error condition is if book.getName equals book.getSQL of .getName error, a book cannot be a sequel of itself. And again, the second parameter is the demo package. And this time we want the error to appear on the sequel of. So we'll save that again now. And now we can see that we do have an error, and the error message is a book cannot be a sequel of itself. So that's good. That's what we want.